वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन फॉर द प्रोज क्लास लेसन नंबर 12 चिट्टी चिट्टी बैंग बैंग बाय फ्रैंक कोट्रेल बॉयस। अबाउट द ऑथर, फ्रैंक कोट्रेल बॉयस बॉर्न 23 सितंबर इज एन इंग्लिश स्क्रीन राइटर, नॉवलिस्ट एंड ऑकेजनल एक्टर। ही इज नोन फॉर चिल्ड्रंस फिक्शन एंड इज फेमस फॉर द स्वीकल्स He wrote to Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, The Magical Car, a children's classic by Ian Fleming. Let's begin the lesson. Most cars are just cars. Four wheels, an engine, some seats. They take you to work or to school. Then they bring you home again. The Tooting family car was not one of these. Tooting means short, sharp sound. The Tooting family car was different. The Tooting family car was a beautiful green, perfectly restored 1921 Paragon Panther, the only one ever built. Her wheels flashed in the sunshine. Flashed means shine intermittently. Her long majestic bonnet gleamed means shine brightly. Her seats were as soft as silk, and the instruments on her walnut dashboard sparkled like summer. The glossy ebony handle of her chronogester glowed invitingly. Most cars don't have a chronogester. It's a special handle that allows you to drive backward and forward in time. Dear children, what is chronogester? Chronogester means it's a special handle that allows you to drive backward and forward in time. That's how special Chitty Chitty Bang Bang is. Time travel is fitted as standard. If an ordinary car breaks down, it might end up in a lay-by with steam coming out of the engine. When the Tooting family car broke down, it ended up in an ancient steaming jungle being eyed by a hungry dinosaur. A very large animal. Dinosaur means a very large animal. Dinosaur and little Harry. He seemed to think that the rest of his family might not have noticed the gigantic head swaying over the treetop's drooling spit and billowing its hunger. Gigantic means large. It's describing words. It's an adjective. Drooling means it's a saliva flowing out. Jallu surisu. Billowing means kirichu, shouting. Dinosaur and little Harry again. Dinosaur and little Harry again. And means it's a verb. Shouting. Shout loudly. None of them had ever seen such a creature before. No living being has ever seen such creature. Creature means animal. It's a noun. But all of them, even little Harry, knew what it was. Tyrannosaurus Rex. It's a king of the tyrant lizards. Hang on. Everyone yelled, Dad. Jem, watch the back. We are going to reverse. Dad pushed hard on the accelerator and yanked means pull with jerk. It's a verb. The gears around. Black smoke billowed from the exhaust. Sludge splattered into the air. Sludge means wet mud. It's a noun. They were called chitty chitty bang bang mood, 6 inches down into the mud. Then her engine stopped. Why has engine stopped? Asked mom. It's just stalled. Stalled means stop running. It's verb, said dad. No one said a word. They were all thinking the same thing. To start the engine, someone would have to get out of the car and turn the crank. Crank means start the engine. It's a verb. If we just sit tight, maybe it won't see us and we will be safe. Or maybe it will see the car and think, oh, tinned, two things, muttered mom. Tin means covered in a can. It's an adjective. Muttered means say in a low voice. It's a verb. Or maybe it will crush us underfoot, said Lucy. Crush means break forcefully. It's verb. Burying us in mud so that over the years we turn into fossils. Fossils means past impressions. And in millions of years, we will be one of the great mysteries. Means impossible to explain. Mysteries means impossible to explain. Of science, a family of humans that somehow managed to get themselves fossilized in the age of dinosaurs. We will be the great tooting conundrum. Conundrum means difficult problem. It's a noun. Except they won't know our name was tooting. The head loomed closer. The head appeared closer. Loomed means appear. It's a verb. It was so vast that Jem felt like he was staring at something through a microscope. Staring means look fixedly. It's a verb. He could see the bits of mud and twigs caught in the folds of its pebbly skin, the stains of blood on its white dagger teeth. Twigs means stem. Pebbly means smooth. It's an adjective. Its tongue was as rough as a gravel path. Gravel means loose stones. Its nostrils were a pair of wet, grungy bin lids. Grungy means dirty. It's an adjective. Its eye a tiny twitchy rivet. Twitchy means nervous. It's an adjective. Maybe it won't see us, thought Jem. But just as he thought that, those bin lid nostrils twitched. Nostrils means moogina hollegalu. They closed up. They opened again. The tyrannosaur had sniffed, means moosu. And its sniff was so powerful that every leaf and branch rattled, means knocking sound. And Lucy's hair went flying round her head. It was sniffing for food. It had definitely sniffed out the tootings. Fascinating, said Lucy. Fascinating means interesting. It's a adjective. For years now, there has been a debate about whether Tyrannosaurus rex was a true predator, able to move fast and catch and kill its prey. Predator means parabhakshaka. It will eat a living animal. Or whether it was just a very big scavenger. Scavenger means animal eating dead animals. Eating only animals that were already dead. Why is that interesting, said Jem, because if it is a scavenger, it will leave us alone. But if it is a predator, it will kill us. Actually, that is quite interesting. There was a sound like the sound that a house might make it if someone picked it up and dropped it from a great height. It was the creature's foot, landing a few yards in front of them. Its curved, cruel claws means sharp nails, dug into the earth as it steadied itself. Steadied means not moving. Its toes stretched like leathery bridges. Its leg was a tower of meat. Under the skin, chains of muscle shifted like the gears of a terrible machine. On balance, said Lucy, I am going to say predator. Dear children, from this lesson, we have come across the grammar part, preposition of time, place and direction. A preposition is a word used to link nouns, pronouns or phrase to other words within a sentence. Prepositions are usually short words and they are normally placed directly in front of nouns. A preposition can indicate either time, this week, at 9 a.m. on Saturday, or place, in India, at a station between two platforms, or direction, on, under, over, in, between, through. That's all for today's class, children. Take care. Bye-bye.